Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Wednesday morning. It's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with today's look at Canadian stock market trends. In the pre-market this morning, the TSX 60 futures are down a dollar. Crude oil is lower while gold is higher by $2 in the pre-market on Wednesday morning. Now, if you're one of those people managing long-term money, you know that we got a lot of sell signals over the weekend. And if you sold at the open yesterday morning, congratulations, you basically got out at the high of the day. So that helped a little bit. The markets were down yesterday. New closing low for the iShares for the TSX 60. New low yesterday for the Spider ETF and the Qs for the NASDAQ. We saw a slightly higher high for the VIX yesterday, but looking to break out of those highs from last week. Things would change on Wednesday with a close for the VIX below 23.61. Now, moving over and breaking the market down by sector, we didn't see a lot of love on Tuesday with a little love going into base metals. That's probably because the price of copper moved up, but you can see certainly no change in trend there. And then what didn't work, well, cannabis stocks were the big losers, and of course they're part of the healthcare sector. Then we've got energy stocks still on a sell signal, no change there. No change for consumer discretionary, making a new closing low yesterday. And then just tailing off, looking at the financials and banking stocks, no love for either of those. We do have the Bank of Canada coming out today with new interest rates and announcements, and that could put additional pressure on those stocks. Looking at the volume leaders, well, if we just walk through here, you're not going to see a lot of love for any of these stocks until you get down to Canadian Natural Resources. That one is holding up fairly well compared to everything else on this list. And you have to keep going past the top 10, certainly. There's the TD Bank holding up fairly well compared to the rest of the banking sector. There's Manulife, there's Barrick. Now, the Canadian National Railways making a new low for this move yesterday. You have to go farther down the list to find a winner on from Tuesday, and that's Intact Insurance, which popped yesterday, is back on a buy signal. If you've been waiting to buy this stock, well, this is the time and place to do it, but it is up at the top of the recent highs, so it's going to take something extra to be able to break through those highs at the moment. So if you don't follow this stock, this isn't a buy signal I would take. If you do follow this stock, especially if you were short this stock, you want to take care of things on Wednesday morning. Now, looking at currencies, of course, we can be depressed on how the Canadian dollar looks, but it really doesn't have much to do with the Canadian dollar, because you can see other major currencies like the Australian dollar and the British pound look pretty damn similar. It has a lot to do with money continuing to flow into the US dollar. There's probably a lot of people around the world worried about recession and economic calamity in their countries, and they're going in buying U.S. dollars, which unfortunately is making U.S. exports more expensive to everyone else around the world, and that's probably not good for the U.S. economy. Let's finish off with commodities, and we saw crude oil up slightly on the day. Looking at the futures contract, it's still in a tight range here, and you can see we had a low back in July. If we break that, then $75 comes into play. And you can see if we take out last week's high, then 100 and 106.25 come into play. But right now, we're not really heading anywhere at the moment, unlike natural gas, which had a big down day yesterday. So a lot of talk about natural gas issues in Europe, and that's not really helping natural gas here in North America. Then looking at copper traded higher yesterday, still on a sell signal, no change there. That helped the base metals yesterday. Then gold was down yesterday, another $9.70, still trading above last week's low. And then silver was actually unchanged on Tuesday, so no extra hatred for silver on Tuesday. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. It looks like there's going to be some selling at the open on Wednesday morning. Have a great day. Next time you'll hear my voice is on Thursday morning.